development of this law was triggered by the PCB contamination case in the later 60s. And government to recognize general control of industrial chemicals at that time. And then the law, implementation of the law was, the law was established and entered into force in 1973. So it was a relatively old law. But after that, this was revised several times. So the first law is basically focused on the ban of PBT chemicals like PCB, and also introduced the new chemical notification scheme. So that is why the first new chemical notification scheme under the first law is focused on to prevent the marketing of PBT. It means if the chemical is not persistent or not bioaccumulative, there's no need for other information like human toxicity. And then amendment of 1986 is to introduce some the regulation on the chemicals that is not bioaccumulative. So let me talk about the new chemical notification. So this is a kind of fraud scheme whether your chemicals has to be notified to the authority or not. So chemical substance control law exclude elements or substance occurring in nature. That means one significant example is CSCL does not cover asbestos. The second phase is kind of the chemical substance regulated by other regulations. So if some specific regulations listed here, you don't need to apply to CSCL. So after that, you have to check existing chemical list and evaluated chemical list. The your chemical is solely for the research and development, you don't need to notify that. But if your chemical is some intermediate or export only or low volume or PLC, there is a specific confirmation scheme. So you can go to the confirmation scheme. You don't, for the confirmation scheme, basically you don't need to provide some hazard property information. So the next one is a kind of a diagram to explain this one in more detail. So there are several opportunities. So if your chemical is not biodegradable, you can look at the molecular body and molecular weight. If molecular weight is sufficiently high, you don't need to provide information of BCF. And if not, you can consider to provide log POW. But if log POW is not sufficiently low or is not applicable to the chemical, you have to conduct a BCF test, TG305. And the worst case scenario is your chemical exceed, BCF will be your chemical exceed 5,000. You have to provide a very expensive test result, and this never happened so far during this 40 years of implementations. So it means the CSCL prevent the marketing of bioaccumulative chemicals. So this diagram doesn't mention about the lidocrous or some lidocrous or accusers, but there is a possibility to do some lidocrous or accusers. Next, I talk about the comprehensive assessment. So the annual, under the CCL, we request you to provide a manufacturer and import amount, and also request you to provide the information on usage. There is a threshold is prepared for import, 10% in mixtures and for general chemicals. and 1% in mixture as impurity for the priority assessment chemicals. So the result of reporting is we receive some 30,000 reports every year. If you're interested in the Japanese market, you have to open your eyes. So thank you for your attention. And if you have time, please visit NITE's website.